So YouTube is redesigning the channel profile pages again. Hooray! Or not, as the case may be. So, the sharp-eyed amongst you may have noticed that I've switched my channel over to the brand new design, which is a little bit controversial. But then, every time YouTube changes something, it's always controversial. Now, I don't want to get into a great long argument about how ugly this new channel design is or how it's taking away our creativity and so on. That is something that I do have my opinions on, but in this video, I'm just going to give you a few tips of my own so that you can prepare for it. The fact is that whatever you or I think of the new design, YouTube is committed to it. At the moment, it's opt-out. You can still go to youtube.com/onechannel and scroll right down to the bottom of the page and you'll find a button where you can opt out. But that's not going to last forever because eventually YouTube is going to switch everybody permanently over to the new design. I know, everybody hates it, nobody wants it, but that's going to happen, so we have to live with it. Given that it is coming, I think it's probably helpful to understand why it's coming from an engineering point of view. The clue is in the title. It's called One Channel for a reason. The point is that these days, more and more people are using different devices to watch their YouTube videos on. It's no longer just at a desktop PC like the one behind me, but also on smartphones, tablet PCs, and at the other end of the scale, games consoles and TVs. And so it gets a little bit difficult trying to come up with a design that works equally well on all of these platforms. You see, at the moment with the current design, you get to design a channel background, and if you are a branded partner, you also get to design a banner, but those only show up on desktop PCs. They don't show up, for example, if you see your channel on a mobile phone. More and more people are using smartphones to access YouTube, and so the idea is that you get to design one piece of artwork, and that one piece of artwork should serve as a banner on all devices. Now, that's a concept that a lot of people apparently are having a lot of trouble with, the idea that one web page can look very different on different devices. One source of confusion is that when you make your channel art, as it's called, to the specified dimensions, which is those, you upload it and it tells you that you have an option to crop it, but unfortunately the cropping tool doesn't work. People are expecting to be able to crop to the area that shows up as a banner on desktop PCs, but that's not how channel art works. So how does it work? Well, this is the image that I uploaded to YouTube. This is my channel art. I uploaded it at the recommended dimensions, so that's why I cannot use the cropping tool to crop it any further. It is already exactly the right size. This is the size that it's got to be to upload properly to YouTube. This is what I'm using. This is the whole design, but I only get to see the whole design if I look at my YouTube channel on TV. Then I get to see the whole picture, but if I'm using any other kind of device whatsoever, then I only get to see a small portion of the image, a slice across the middle, which then looks like a banner. And that's what you've got to do. That's the way that the one channel design works. It works as a whole image on television, but as a banner on every other device. So, the full image I get to see on TV, this is what I get to see on a smartphone, and this is what I get to see on a tablet PC. And if I use a desktop, then I see a variable width banner that gets wider or narrower as I increase or decrease the size of the browser. Now, what you can't see, because Bonnie is blocking the computer monitor. Get down, Bonnie. There's a good girl. Go on. YouTube has put up a... So, as I was saying, YouTube has put together a page of guidelines for you to follow so that you can design your channel art properly. And I've put a link to it in the video description. Bonnie, don't you dare sit on the remote control. So basically, the upshot of it is that you've got to cram your logo and anything else that absolutely must appear on your channel banner when it is viewed on any device at all, from the smallest to the biggest, inside an area with these dimensions right in the middle of your channel art. This area here. Anything that goes in there will always be displayed, no matter what device you view it on. But that's not quite all, because you also have to bear in mind that if you see your channel on a desktop PC, your avatar will be superimposed over it. Not only that, but the avatar will also move as you widen and narrow the browser window. And the same goes for the links, which go in a little rectangular space near the bottom right of the banner area. And again, this space can move. So you've got to be careful and make sure that you leave space for all of these elements. Okay, that sounds really complicated. So let's just kind of break it down a little bit. Number one, if you upload an image to the recommended dimensions, you cannot use the cropping tool because that is the size it is. That's the recommended size. There's nothing left to crop. Number two, depending on what you use to view your YouTube channel, you will see a bigger or a smaller area of the channel art. And number three, anything that goes in this area will always be visible, no matter what device you view your channel on. So that's about it. Once again, please don't complain to me. I'm not going to get drawn into a discussion about how ugly or sterile the new design is. Unfortunately, that is the new design. We will be switched over to it permanently, and YouTube is committed to it. So I just hope that I've been able to give you a few pointers so that the changeover is not too dramatic for you. But any complaints, please address them to YouTube and not to me. Thank you.